Well, you know the saying, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, and that may be especially true when it comes to stress. So instead of sweating the small stuff, you may want to embrace your stress and learn from it. The Fox Medical Team's Beth Galvin is here to talk about the upside of being stressed out.
Oh, you're going to have to convince me of this one.
Well, you know, this is really interesting because this is really kind of an eye-opener for me because, you know, as a health reporter, I'm always talking about how bad chronic stress can be for our health, but it turns out stress can make us stronger and smarter if we can embrace it and learn from it.
Whether it's the work that can't wait, the traffic that never seems to end, or that task that we don't feel ready for, we can't escape stress. It's part of life.
The question always comes up, why do some people thrive under stress, and why do other people just have stress destroy their life and their quality of life?
And Emory internist Dr. Sharon Burquest believes the difference between people who are overwhelmed by stress and those who overcome it comes down to resilience and how we view stress.
So people who try and avoid stress tend to have very low resilience, whereas people who survive from really traumatic events in their life tend to view stress as something that's unavoidable.
Because a little bit of stress may be good for our brains. Research shows each time we work our way through a challenging situation, our brains recover and rewire themselves to learn from that experience. So you know how we get shots as kids? Well, going through hard times may give us a stress inoculation, helping to vaccinate us against stress by giving us the experience and the knowledge we need to withstand the next challenge down the road.
If you take the college student who crams for that test and goes to a test, next time he feels more confident that he can really do well in that class.
So if you want to get better and smarter, jump in. What doesn't kill you may very well indeed make you stronger.
Look at it as an opportunity to learn. Look at it as a challenge. And just by doing that, your brain can start to really secrete these hormones that help you really learn from it and do better the next time.
All right, so if you've got that deadline that's looming over you today, or you have something else on your mind that's really stressing you out, try switching gears in your head. And instead of procrastinating, just do it. And instead of sitting around dreading it and mulling over everything that can go wrong, try to look at this big thing ahead of you as a challenge and a learning opportunity, because the stress in our lives isn't going to go away, so we might as well make a little peace with it, Karen.
And let's talk about that soundtrack, that negative soundtrack that pops up almost instantly when you're under stress. Oh, I can't do this. I'm going to fall apart. I mean, that automatically, I think you have to literally talk yourself out of that.
Yeah, I think you have to switch the message in your head that you're giving yourself from I can't do it to maybe I should just try it. I probably can do it, you know, because you never know. And what's the worst thing that's going to happen to you? You're going to fail. You're going to learn from it. You know, it's not the end.
I do know that's how positive people handle stress, you know, but there's also a good stress and a bad stress.
Yeah, and I think the bad stress is really that sort of unrelenting stress that is eating away at you, because, you know, when we feel stressed, our adrenaline rushes up, you know, and if we never, and our cortisol, you know, our body's pumping out cortisol, we've got that fight or flight thing. If we don't have a way to relax from that, if we don't have a way to let go from that, that constant elevated adrenaline, cortisol can really wear us down. And that's where we start to talk about the negative stress. So really finding outlets, not just to, you know, not just your attitude, but outlets to sort of lower the stress in your life, whether it's exercise or meditation, all those things can be really helpful.
I wholeheartedly agree. All right, Beth, thank you so much for that.